About two-thirds of Canadians, they are impacted by the taking time off to get ready to go on vacation.
As if Canadians want another tax, but it appears we're being hit by the time off tax. According to a survey from workplace firm ADP, the average worker is putting in significant overtime just to prepare to take their vacation.
Up to 27 hours that they have to invest to get ready to go to vacation. And that's almost a three-day work period.
To make matters worse, 45% of Canadians can't disconnect from work when they're on vacation, regularly checking their work email.
If leaders are taking time off and they connect to their online, obviously, you know, the more junior folks see that and they feel obligated or obliged to do the same.
So, do Canadians just hate taking vacations? Well, 51% of Canadians don't take all of their allotted days in a year, with 5% saying they don't take any at all. But while Canadians may be working longer hours, it may be a case of quantity over quality.
It is a productivity impact to organizations. You know, would you rather afford the people the time off at a, you know, a point in time, as opposed to not affording them the time off and they're not really adding the value or adding to the bottom line as you would expect them to do?
Now, Canadians aren't alone in failing to establish a separation between work and play, but some countries have seemingly fared well in striking that balance.
Italy and France, they have it down to a fine art, and I think people take their vacation, their allotted vacation, and they totally disconnect us from work.
So, what can we do to truly, completely enjoy our vacations? Setting your out-of-office email notification is a must, and so too is setting down the work phone. But ultimately, your boss needs to step up to ensure your downtime.
The leaders have a responsibility to accommodate the employee in such a way that they make available resources to back up the employee when they do go on vacation.
In Edmonton, Courtney Theriault, City News.